Hey everyone! Now available for free, the revised Automotive Materials collection includes a set of 10 master materials and over 150 instances, giving artists the foundation to add new materials to fit their products. Plus, all materials are now simpler, more organized, more efficient, and, best of all, more fun to use. Download the collection today and try it for yourself. Recently, we welcomed Cubic Motion to the Epic Games family. Cubic Motion has been a longtime Epic partner, integral to notable real-time demonstrations such as the first Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice live character performance, Meet Mike, and Siren. They are a leading provider of automated performance-driven facial animation technology and services for video games, film, broadcast, and immersive experiences. By joining forces, our teams are solidifying our commitment to advancing the state of the art in the creation of believable digital humans for all Unreal Engine users. For the sound designers in the audience, senior technical sound designer Adam Block wrote up a thorough dev blog on his audio redesign of the shooter game sample project, where he not only made the soundscape more modern and dynamic, but updated how the sounds were implemented. For a deep dive, head over to the Unreal Engine blog. And once you've finished with your lesson on sound design, check out a piece from Epic's lead audio programmer Aaron McLaren on Unreal Engine's split-screen support, originally rolled out for Fortnite Season 11. McLaren describes how split-screen audio works in Unreal, some of the challenges of implementing it, and why, in the case of split-screen audio, your intuition may not always be right. Interactive 3D started in the games industry, but this technology is now being used everywhere, from advertising to manufacturing, architecture, healthcare, film, and more. As more and more employers embrace this technology, the demand for real-time 3D skills is skyrocketing. We'd like to introduce the Creators Field Guide to Emerging Careers in Interactive 3D, a free roadmap for students and job seekers to help navigate the exciting world of interactive 3D careers and provide guidance on the specific skills and competencies these new roles require. Download the Creators Field Guide to Careers in Interactive 3D via the Unreal Engine blog. If you're an Android developer, please know that Unreal Engine 4.25 requires Android Native Development Kit Revision 21 to support the development of Android projects. This requires a new setup process using Android Studio. While new documentation will be published on this process for 4.25's full release, for those of you trying out the 4.25 previews, you can check out the new setup steps ahead of time on our blog. You may have seen the Mills work on The Human Race, previously showcased at GDC in 2017, or perhaps our spotlight on their use of Unreal Engine to puppet the monster for Monster.com's award-winning advertising series called Opportunity Roars. Watch their latest short and a brief behind the scenes to see how they crossed the finish line to deliver a piece that seamlessly blends digital and physical reality for Sky's Formula One's 2020 coverage, with the help of Sky Creative. And over to our top weekly karma earners, Clockwork Ocean, GeoDVS, Vicherka, Deathray, Ujimo, Foxfire, Nuxit, Grot13, T. Sumisaki, and Rumerayaki. Thank you all for your contributions. Our first spotlight this week is a stunning tech demo from Black Amber Digital, specialists in high-end cinematics and games. They wanted to see what was possible with ray tracing for a game that runs in 4K at 60 FPS, and they impressed. If you'd like to stay up to date on Zenobia, formerly Origin Zero, follow them at twitter.com/Zenobia_game. Here you see a beautiful Blacksmith setup by Art Attack. They're utilizing Quixel Megascans and are also showing off ray tracing techniques. Head over to the forums to share your comments and suggestions. Nice work. The final spotlight is from Daisuke Sakamoto, and they made these Gibson LesPaul guitars sing. Not only did they build a stunning cinematic, they've also created a guitar configurator and virtual showroom using the Oculus Rift S. Again, jump over to the forums and let Daisuke know what you think. All right, thanks for tuning in to this week's news and community spotlight.